Meghalaya Pradesh Congress Committee kelak penremjur ya ke sarkar NDA belailam na ke BJP namar ke jingkenta ban ai visa ya presiden ke Populist World Alliance Dr. Paul Cesar ringkat kiwe kenangilam ke BWA ki batumu ban wan ya shimanta ke jingrakhi dap chi spa sampausnam ke Garo Baptist Church ke belabu ban long menta banai rempang habakren menta ke sengi working president ke Meghalaya Pradesh Congress Committee ba Vincent H. Pala ulak thier ya ke sarkar NDA na ke baong bakani kejing kentaj manai visa ya ke reunion balang kristan kibawa na syabar kede kejing iben ya ke kenhon red pad hakari bat ke bamla wan pedang ba pala ulai itu ulai ya kren ya kani ke benta bat ki he ke ministry of external affairs bat ke lapun tip ba ki dang ya kren bat ki ambassador ke indian house of africa uhe ke Meghalaya Pradesh Congress Committee ulak kentaj ba ke kongres kashim ya kani kamat na ke benta ban yonong election berulang bakani kejing le jang sarkar NDA banam ai visa yakinong ilap kristan kamde tang menta hendai ka BJP kala le ru hakis nem meladam
the rejection of visa to Dr. Paul who is the president of the Baptist World Alliance who based in South Africa I personally had a talk with the office of Sushma Swaraj in Delhi they told me that the notice or the message has been sent to the ambassador of India in South Africa, but till now I think they haven't got the visa, and the conference is already started from today. And this information has been given to her long back from the Baptist Church, but I think intentionally they want to insult the church. So we condemned this, and whoever comes to India, they welcome the businessmen, they welcome everybody, but not to the church leaders. So this is a very bad. I think there is nothing but a discrimination to the Christianity in India. These are signs of intolerance to the Christianity or to minority in India. So I think all of us here we should condemn such action. Number two is that. This is not the first instance which they have rejected the visa. Many other instances which I have even taken with the Prime Minister's office and the Home Minister for the region of Shah. Whenever the missionaries are coming to India, they always have a delay and different tactics just to discourage them to come. So I think what the BJP government in Delhi has done through the Ministry of External Affairs, I think is not as per the constitutions that we can't, as per Christians, we can worship whatever we want, we can eat whatever we want, But what they are trying to dictate us, that we should worship according to their will, that we should eat according to their will. So this, we condemned all these actions.
The Saffron Brigade will stop at nothing to spread their message, agenda of Hindutva. The RSS chief, I would like to give an example, Mohan Bhagavat. Had even ridiculed the much revered Saint Mother Teresa and said that Mother Teresa, when she worked for the service of the poor and downtrodden, she had an ulterior motive, which is how he wanted to place Mother Teresa's work. And we deny this kind of mindset and we condemn this kind of mindset because we know this same mindset also we see in their attack on churches. The same mindset encourages the attack on churches where young people want, where people go to pray with young children and where they attack on people's lives, their culture, the way of life, as Mr. Pala had said, their way of life, the eating habits, the culture. So they want to saffronize the whole of India with Hindutva agenda. So this visa denial cannot be seen as one thing only, but also as a whole of a agenda of Hindutva. This is what we want to say, and this is what we want to convey and condemn.